Angela.
And I know it's weird, like I just feel like I've watched you grow up from when you first, you know, came out as an artist and to see where you are today. Your album just came out as we're filming this yesterday.
Yes.
And there's 27 songs.
27.
Yeah, State of Emerge and See.
Yes.
Part 3.
Mm-hmm.
So let's get into it because we were discussing how, first of all, it's been a while since you've been doing interviews.
Absolutely.
And you even said you're like a little nervous.
I am. I'm trying to, I'm sure it's evident. I'm trying to, you know, calm myself down a little bit. You know, as exciting as it is when you get to put out music and express yourself through your art, the amount of energy that you receive from it and from people is a lot to take on. The same way they say about God, when two or more are gathered in his name, that's when you channel and bring in the presence of God. And I feel like it's the same way with people when the energy and intention is set on you, you know, whether good or bad, you feel that. It's exciting and invigorating, but it, you know, it's a little nerve-wracking at times.
It's part of the process. And you put out the documentary series also.
Mm-hmm.
And it's a 5-part docuseries. And I feel like we really got to learn so much about you. I know we know some things about you, which really connects people to your music.
Yeah.
Just because there's some common things that sometimes we look at celebrities and celebrities seem so perfect. But you've, I think, always been really honest about things you've been going through in your life. And this dug even deeper into it. So I do want to talk about that. How long were you filming that?
I started to film that, I think, way back in 2015. So for it to finally come together, it's really been a long time coming. And, you know, part of it was, you know, due to time.
Mm-hmm.
But another part of it was also, I felt like I was still in the process and kind of still in the oven baking and still trying to give birth to it. And, you know, to see it finally come together, it's beautiful. But the other side of it was that I was probably a little nervous, you know, to open myself up like that in that kind of a way. It feels like, you know, being completely stripped naked in front of the eyes of the world. And I think deeper than stripped naked, it feels like as if my body were turned inside out. It's been a long time coming, but I felt it was so necessary because everybody's so worried about
what people think.
Yeah. The purpose for me was to hopefully be a voice to people in the world by exposing myself through the art and hopefully allowing people to see themselves through it as well.
You have an episode on what is love.
Absolutely.
And one thing that people ask, like, who is August linked to romantically? Because you're never very open about that. Like, we've seen you, you know, out on dates, and we've assumed certain things.
Mm-hmm.
And I remember you put out this song, Nanya, and a lot of people were saying, okay, you know, August is dating Jada Pinkett Smith, and that was something that was circulating as a rumor, and that kind of solidified it to people. So what was the real situation with Jada Pinkett Smith? Because I don't know if you were pursuing her or you guys had just a close family type of relationship, and I would love for you to be able to shed that.
Here's what I'll say. People can have whatever ideas that they like, but what I'm not okay with is my character, you know, being in question.
Mm-hmm.
When certain things are questionable that I know is not me, or that I know that I haven't done, you know, contrary to what some people may believe, I'm not a troublemaker. You know, I don't like drama. Drama actually makes me nauseous, you know what I'm saying? And I also don't think that it's ever important for people to know what I do, who I sleep with, who I date, right? But in this instance, it's very different because, as I said, there's so many people that are side-eyeing me, looking at me questionable about it. I mean, I've lost money, friendships, relationships behind it. And I think it's because people don't necessarily know the truth, but I've never done anything wrong. Mm-hmm. I love those people, right. Literally, like my family. I don't have a bad thing to say about them. They are beautiful people. You know, when something starts affecting my life, and not only affecting my life, but affecting my wellness and my well-being, and also starts to block my heart space is blocked. I don't really have a choice but to express my truth. I actually sat down with Will and had a conversation due to the transformation from their marriage to life partnership that they've spoken on several times, and it, you know, not involving romanticism. Mm-hmm. He gave me his blessing, and I totally gave myself to that relationship for years of my life, you know, and I truly and really, really deeply loved and have a ton of love for her. I devoted myself to it. I gave my full self to it. So much so to the point that I can die right now and be okay with knowing that I truly gave myself to somebody.
Right, you did the right thing.
And I really loved a person. I experienced that. I know what that feels like. And some people never get that in this lifetime. So I know that I'm completely blessed. And this conversation is difficult because there's so much that it would be hard for people to understand. But once it starts to affect me and my livelihood, I have to speak up about my truth and stand on my 10 with anything that may come along with it.
Is it disappointing that she never addressed it to you? Because, like you said, you lost out on opportunities.
Yeah.
And if there's
I really can't even, I never even can get into the thought of that because I'm only responsible for myself, right? And I'm only responsible for, you know, what I do. When I'm repressing and suppressing things, and it starts to affect me, I have to address it. I just always stay silent because I never want to be the person to cause confusion because I love these people.
Right.
I really genuinely do. And I have literally never been in love in that kind of a way. So much so that being intertwined in that way, walking away from it, butchered me. Like I'm shaking right now because
it almost
killed me. It did. It pushed me into being another person, my newer self. It broke me down. It was a part of me being paralyzed, trying to pull myself apart from it. It probably will be the hardest thing that I've ever experienced in this lifetime. And, you know, it's difficult because I never want to be the person to cause any confusion or step on toes, right?
You want to be honest.
But I want to honor myself and I want to honor my authenticity. And if honoring my authenticity means you hate me, stone me, shoot me, crucify me, whatever, bury me an honest man.